हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज आकाश सर हियर एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग मेक इजी। ओके, इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स एंड दिस इज फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स। ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड विद मैकेनिक्स एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स। सो दिस टू सब्जेक्ट्स आर वी कैन से इंटरडिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर। सो फर्स्टली वी विल कंसिडर दैट। सो मैकेनिक्स is nothing but solid mechanics which have two types. First is mechanics of rigid bodies and mechanics of deformable bodies. Okay, and in case of engineering mechanics we have studied the mechanics that is nothing but mechanics of rigid bodies. Okay, this is engineering mechanics. And mechanics of deformable bodies, this we are going to study in strength of material, or in some books there is another name, that is mechanics of materials. Strength of material or mechanics of material, both are the same thing. And this is the classification as solid mechanics, rigid bodies and deformable bodies. Mechanics of rigid body is nothing but engineering mechanics, and mechanics of deformable body, that is nothing but strength of material. Okay, so now we will move some deep of strength of material. As we have covered the rigid bodies mechanics, now we are moving with deformable bodies mechanics. So today's lecture we are going to move with some basic concepts. So then superposition principle. What is superposition principle? Superposition principle is nothing but for any elastic member, the load effect caused by, I will give you example. For example, this is one elastic member. Okay, and this member have two forces. Maybe one is here and another is here. This will be F1, this will be F2. What will happen? As this is elastic member and fixed at both the points, both the ends, so ultimately the deformation will happen here. Okay, but how much amount of deformation will happen because of F1 and F2, that will depend on the summation of the individual deformation will occur because of F1 and because of F2. So what exactly the principle of superposition? That is nothing but the load effect caused by two or more loadings is sum of load effects caused by each loading separately. Okay, means we will consider each loading separately and the summation of that all loadings will give us combined loading effect. Okay, this is nothing but principle of superposition. Then again, this equation is valid for a number of cases, but there are some cases there this equation is not valid. That is nothing but superposition principle is not valid for some points. Okay, so not valid for, which are that cases? First is deep beam. If there is a case of deep beam, in that case the superposition principle is not going to valid. Then next is strain energies. Okay, then next is non-circular members. Means only for circular members the superposition principle is going to valid. For non-circular members the superposition principle is not going to valid for that case. Then next is subjected to torsion. Okay, non-circular member subjected to torsion. If non-circular members are there and that members are subjected to torsion, then the superposition principle is not valid for that. But if non-circular members are and that not subjected to torsion, they are subjected to simple stresses like bending and etc. So in that case the superposition principle will be valid for that. Okay, so these are three cases for which the superposition principle is not valid. So note down these cases, these are also too much important. Then we will move towards next topic, that is nothing but Saint Venant's principle. (Clears throat) ओके व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज नथिंग बट सेंट वेनेंट्स प्रिंसिपल. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली सेंट वेनेंट्स प्रिंसिपल सेज टू अस दैट इज इफ दिस इज वन बॉडी ओके एंड ऑन दिस बॉडी आई हैव अप्लाइड वन पॉइंट लोड हियर ओके आई हैव अप्लाइड वन पॉइंट लोड हियर that you can may take their one weight or anything. I have simply said one point load. Okay. So at this moment, what are the stresses looks like? The stresses will be, okay, at the center, the stress is maximum. Okay. This is the stress distribution and at the center where I have applied this force at that point the stresses are maximum okay but if we will go towards downward then here what will happen that will have some smooth curve again stress at center is maximum here also but at another points also the stress curve have taken one smooth curve okay at the some distance from the application of force but if we will move towards very large distance from the application of force then in that case what will happen that force effect will be directly neglected and the stress at all the points will be same okay if we will move with some large distance from the application of force then at that point what will happen the stress effect will be directly neglected and the stress at all the points of that body will be same and this is nothing but strength Wenand's principle okay so what exactly that is the difference between effect of two different but statistically equivalent loads becomes very small at sufficiently large distance from loads okay we have applied load here and we have taken sufficiently large distance between these two points so ultimately what happened at this point we will get one value of stress and that will be constant for all the points the effect of this force is actually neglected here okay this is the case of Saint Venant's principle so draw this figure And if you have any doubt, then you can ask me in comment box. Otherwise, I will move. Very simple principle it is. Only if we are moving some large distance apart from application of force, then that application of force point at which the sigma max should be there. But because of that some large distance, that sigma max will be directly neglected and stresses at all the points will be same. Okay. Now we will move towards stress. What is stress? Stress is nothing but the internal resistance set up per unit cross sectional area. Okay, what is stress? The internal resistance set up per unit cross sectional area. For example, if this is one rod and we have applied one force P, tensile force P. So because of this tensile force P, what will happen? The stress will be generated. And what exactly the stress is? As we are pulling this rod from both the ends so this is nothing but tensile load so ultimately the resistance will occur to reduce that tensile deformation okay to resist that tensile deformation the one force will be developed internal force or internal resistance that is called as stress so here that stress will equal to force per unit area of cross section okay cross sectional area will be there This is nothing but stress. So stress also have two types. First is okay. First is normal stress, and another is shear stress. So normal stress is nothing but tensile stress and compressive stress. And in case of shear stress, the one type of shear stress is torsion shear stress. Okay. Torsion is also one type of shear stress and shear stress occurs when for example the shear stress will occur at the cross section for example I am applying force from here so at these two areas the shear stress will develop so shear stress occurs at the cross section and the normal stress occurs along with the axis of that shaft or rod. This is the basics of normal stress and shear stress. This is what all about I have designed for today's lecture, and now we will move towards our last topic, that is nothing but bonus point. Before that, if you are enjoying my session, then please like, share, and if you are new to my channel, then subscribe. Then bonus point. So we know one term, that is nothing but bending stress. Number of times we hears one word, that is nothing but bending stress. So what exactly bending stress? If any component is there and on that component there will be some tensile stresses, plus there will be some compressive stresses. So summation of tensile stress plus compressive stress is nothing but bending stress. And next is shear stress. Okay, as we have taken into consideration that torsion is nothing but one type of shear stress, that is torsion shear stress. Torsion shear stress. So for that the sign convention is nothing but, for clockwise, if that torsion is happening clockwise, then that will be positive. And if that torsion is happening counterclockwise, then that will be have negative sign. Okay, this is sign convention for torsional shear stress. If that torsional shear stress is occurring clockwise, then that will be positive, and that is counterclockwise, then that will be negative. So this is what all about I have designed for today's lecture. And in next lecture I will come up with some again some deep concepts like stresses on inclined plane and strain, etc., etc. So we will meet again. Up till now you can watch my all videos. I will provide some links in description box also. Otherwise you can go to my channel. I have designed separate playlist for all the separate subjects. So go there, watch that all videos, and we will meet again. Thank you, friends.